Link to the source code and transcript in the description. The first approach many people have when they want to use a custom cursor in their game is to place a sprite into a scene and then have it update its position to the mouse's position each frame. The problem with this is that this custom cursor will always be at least one frame behind where the mouse is, which can make the game feel sluggish and unresponsive, even at higher frame rates. So let's take a look at this method real quick to see what's wrong with it. In my scene here, I have a sprite object using a cursor texture, and a simple script on the scene to move the cursor to the position of the player's mouse every frame. But when we start this scene, we can see just how far behind it is from my actual mouse position. So what do we need to do to get a more responsive cursor? We need to use a hardware cursor instead of a software cursor to tie our custom cursor image directly to the mouse. And luckily for us, the developers of Godot have made it incredibly easy to do this. Just open your project settings and go to the mouse cursor tab under the display category. From here, you can choose the image to use as your custom cursor. By default, Godot will match the top left corner of the image to the mouse's position, but if you need to align it with a different part of the image, say the middle of a crosshair graphic, you can adjust the offset in pixels in this window. My crosshair graphic, for instance, is 32 by 32 pixels, so I'm going to change the offset to 16 by 16, that way the center of the crosshair is at the mouse's position. Now when we fire this up in a new scene, we can see that our custom cursor is fast, accurate, and responsive. But what if we want to change our cursor through code, such as showing different images in different contexts? Godot also provides an easy method for this using the input.setCustomMouseCursor function. Using this function, we can change cursor images on the fly or even go back to using the system cursor if desired. The first parameter of this function is the image we want to use as our cursor. You can also pass null to tell Godot to go back to using the native system cursor. The second parameter is the cursor shape we want to override. I'll talk more about this in just a moment, but for now just know that input.cursor_arrow is the default arrow cursor. The final parameter is the offset we want to apply to our graphic if necessary. As an example, I've set up a scene with a simple background that changes from blue to green at the 512th pixel. The code for this scene removes our custom cursor when the mouse moves to a position along the x-axis that is greater than or equal to 512, i.e. over the green area, but adds it back when the new position is less than that, i.e. over the blue area. But if we have to tell Godot which cursor to change, that would imply that we can also use custom cursors for more than just the default arrow cursor. So consider this next example, where I have a basic scene with a line edit inside of it. Now when the mouse enters a line edit, it changes to what's called the I-beam shape. So by using the same set custom mouse cursor function, but changing our second parameter to input.cursor_I-beam, we can tell Godot to use a custom image when we mouse over the line edit. So by using this technique and varying the cursor we want to override, we can use a completely custom set of cursors for all parts of our game if desired. And that's a look at custom cursors in Godot. I'll link to the short page of official documentation in the description, along with a list of all the cursor shapes you can customize if you'd like to know more.